Sinai fled war and imprisonment in Syria, made the treacherous journey across Europe and began a new life in London. A former English teacher, he became an award-winning TV documentary maker and now has volunteered to work as a cleaner at his local London hospital. Mr. Hassan Akkad says the majority of his colleagues there are from immigrant backgrounds. And we can talk to him now from his car outside that hospital as he's about to start his day's work. Mr. Akkad, thank you so much for your time. Now, you volunteered very early on in this COVID-19 crisis. Tell me, you know, what is it like working in the hospital you were at? Quite a frightening task, I imagine.
Thank you so much for having me. Working in a hospital these days is intense, and it plays a physical and a mental toll on you. We are working really long shifts to clean and disinfect the hospital to make sure that the NHS staff and the patients are in a safe and a clean environment. But equally, I am in awe of the people that I'm working with, because my staff, my colleagues are doing such incredible work, from cleaners to porters to ward hosts and nurses and doctors. Everyone is working as a team to combat this pandemic.
Indeed, and a remarkable group of people. Do you have the right protection that you need at all levels of the hospital when it comes to protective masks and clothing and all of that?
So thankfully, in our hospital, Whips Cross, so far we have enough PPE and we have the right protection to keep us safe while we are at work. I mean, you know, this is not the case in every hospital in England, but luckily we have enough protection. And I hope this keeps going, because we do want to carry on doing our jobs, but we want to feel protected and safe as well.
Absolutely. So necessary. Now, I know I've heard you speak in the past naming the amount of different nationalities that make up that very vital work force in that hospital. A lot of people from immigrant backgrounds in a country that, let's face it, wants to drastically reduce and control the number of people moving in from abroad. How does that feel to do such work in the country?
Such an important point, because, you know, before the pandemic hit, especially in the UK, things were not looking great for immigrants and refugees. I mean, Brexit happened because of the fear of immigrants and refugees. But I can tell you about my ward. We are 20 people working in the same ward, and we come literally from every corner of this globe. We are from Nigeria and the Caribbean and Chad and Syria, Poland, Spain, Thailand, and we are all from an immigrant background, but we are all have left our families behind and our friends behind, and we are on the front line to help this community, to help this country combat this coronavirus. And I hope this what we're doing right now, because immigrants and refugees are on the front line in every country, not just Britain. I hope this will start an international discussion about how we treat immigrants and how we value them in our communities.
And when it comes to a local level, are you getting the feeling that, you know, the people you meet or the people around you or in London, that they're starting to look at this issue differently? Like, maybe there is hope that policies might start to change.
Yes, I mean, I do see a change happening, because on a local level, on a national level, people started talking about this. People started realizing the value that immigrants and refugees add to their host communities. And I would like to share something with you. I mean, my story isn't unique, because I'm going to tell you about Germany. There are 14,000 Syrian doctors in Germany waiting to be processed so they can join the front line in Germany. And there are in the EU 31 Syrian doctors who've paid their lives while combating coronavirus. This, again, we will not recover from this pandemic as we were before it. We have to change. We have to be more compassionate and choose love and be more open to people coming from our countries around the world.
Indeed, if anything else, it maybe opened our eyes to thinking on that global level and seeing everybody as the same. I have read, maybe you can tell me a bit more of it, that many of the migrant workers working in the hospitals today don't actually have the same access to the healthcare services that they are providing. Do you know more about that?
I cannot tell you professionally. I don't know. I don't have enough information about the right healthcare that they are provided. But I can tell you about another point, a very important point. In Britain, they want to introduce a new system. It's called the point-based immigration system. And my colleagues, most of them, are categorized as low-skilled workers. So they are the same people who, if this new system goes ahead, they cannot enter this country. So I don't think that moving on, we will introduce this system which will ban these people from coming to this country while they are on the front line trying to save Brits and save people in London and around this country and help them get through this pandemic.
Indeed, one would imagine that a serious discussion will have to be had. Meanwhile, Mr. Akkad, you told me that, you know, when it comes to the clothing, the protective clothing that you have currently in your hospital, enough resources. But are there measures being put in place for the psychological impact of all of this? You know, you're all working at very high levels of stress every day. Are there measures there to help on that front?
Yes. So in our hospital, Webb's Cross, again, we've been given incredible support because they've introduced a new section where we can go for mental well-being, so we can talk to professionals about our day and about our shift, and they can help us process what we are witnessing in there. And they've also, I have to highlight the incredible work of the public, the solidarity, because every day we receive so many incredible gestures, like from muffins to chocolates to produce to so many little things that, you know, they play a huge role to know that the public is behind us and they're supporting us to go through this crisis.
Indeed. And you are doing such a remarkable job going into those hospitals every day, Mr. Akkad. Thanks so much for your time speaking to us here on France 24.
Thank you.